Shouldn't you be getting dressed for dinner? We're due at the Versailles Room in about 25 minutes.
Tonight?
Yeah, tonight. And I told you. I mean, Lee and Gail are coming around here, then we're going out for dinner.
Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot. Well, it would take me a minute to get changed. Is this some occasion?
Well, that depends on your point of view.
What?
We're discussing strategy. And how to beat Luke in the forthcoming election.
Did you see the paper? Luke's picture's on the front page.
So is Lee's.
Yes, yes, I saw that too, but did you read the article?
Not thoroughly, why?
Well, it bears out what most people already think, that Luke can be pretty hard to beat in the election.
Nobody ever said that Lee was going to be a shoo-in.
No, but to most people in Port Charles, Luke is still considered a hero.
Look, love, that was a long, long time ago. The voters want to know what he's going to be doing tomorrow, not way back when.
Yeah, that's true. But I still say that Luke's going to be pretty hard to beat.
All right, so you've said it.
I was just making a comment.
All right, I snapped. I'm sorry. But it's important for you to remember whose side you're on and just who you are.
Who I am? I don't understand.
The wife of the police commissioner, who as such has come out in very strong support of Lee Baldwin.
Is that new?
Oh, well, Holly, you know the answer to that. I should say, what, this old rag? Especially in front of my husband.
Talking about the guy who gets the bills. It looks very nice.
Thank you. I'm so glad you noticed.
Well, Robert, is this the night we plan some brilliant strategy?
Well, Lee, I certainly think we should try.
Well, we need every break we can get. And speaking of breaks, what about that press conference today, huh?
How do you figure that as a break?
Well, I mean, it was all that much, but you know that, confrontation between Brock and Scotty, that did not hurt us.
I see what you mean. But the fact remains, Spencer's going to be a tough man to beat.
Well, we knew that going in. But if he keeps that Brock as his campaign manager, I think that can work in our favor.
Look, in formulating my platform, I think the top priority should be the total opposition to gambling here in Port Charles. Now, do you agree with that?
I agree completely. But especially because you're opposing Luke on this issue, you have to be very careful.
How do you mean? Isn't it an open shut case? Luke is on one side and Lee is on the other.
That's true. But the trick is to oppose Luke's defense of gambling without actually attacking him. In other words, discredit the issue, but not the man himself.
Yes, I agree. I don't want to ask the voter to judge Luke for himself, but for his stand on gambling. See, I wanted to pick Luke as very well-meaning, but just totally misadvised.
I'm glad you feel that way, Lee. I think it's the only approach to take.
What do you think, Holly?
About the election or gambling?
Actually, I'd like to know how you feel about gambling.
Well, if I'm winning, I love it. If I'm losing, it's a different story altogether.
This is a very handsome room, Mr. Spencer.
Oh, the name is Luke, Mr. Sloan.
And my name is Bob. I hope you'll call me that, too, both of you.
Well, that depends on what you write.
Well, I think we'll be friends when it's finished.
I hope so. Would you excuse me for one moment? Connie, order drinks. My usual, please. Ah, please, don't get up. I just wanted to say hello.
Oh, well, it's always good to see you, Luke.
Nice to see you, too, Gail. All of you. Hello, Holly.
Luke?
Lee! We meet again.
Well, I think our paths will be crossing frequently in the near future.
Yes, it seems that way. Oh, well, I seem to have disturbed a strategy session here.
Not really.
Not really. Well, Mr. Commissioner, where do you fit into this little plot?
I wouldn't call it a plot.
You wouldn't?
No, but we are determined.
I like that, Lee, so am I. I won't disturb you any longer. Enjoy your evening.
Thank you.
See you later.
Ladies.
Connie tells me that's your opponent you've just been speaking to.
Yes, Lee Baldwin, that's right.
So you're a gracious candidate.
Well, you could print that. I told them I was a determined candidate.
A candidate with a plan of attack?
Actually, Bob, I got several.
Well, would you mind running through some of them for me?
Not at all.
fascinated.
Sorry, Robert, what did you say?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
All right, then we are agreed. I will draw up my position paper on the gambling issue, and I'll ask you to look at it before I release it, okay?
I'd be glad to, but you know I feel very strongly about this.
Excuse me, there's a call for you, and they said it's urgent.
Excuse me, will you?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. And where is he now? No, I understand. Okay, I'll be on my way. I'm sorry, an emergency's come up. Listen, Lee, I'd appreciate it if you and Gail could see Holly home. I'm not sure when I'm going to be there.
Sure. Is it something serious, Robert?
Well, that remains to be seen. I'll see you at home, but I may be late.
Can I help?
I'll see you at home.
Wonder what it was. I mean, Robert didn't tell us too much.
Now, when you're police commissioner, that's policy.
It's also Robert.
Oh?
Oh, doesn't tell me much what's going on.
I think he's probably just trying to spare you, Holly. I know when I've had a particularly rough day in court, I try not to burden Gail with it.
Yes, I wonder if you could connect me to Miss Constance Townley, please. I believe she's having dinner with Luke Spencer.
Yes, Mr. Spencer and his guest are here. Just one second.
Thank you.
If I say it, don't.
Excuse me, Miss Townley. There's a call for you. Will you take it here?
Sure. I didn't tell anyone I was going to be here. Thank you. Hello?
Listen, I'll do the talking, all right? I'm in the lobby.
Really?
Gerald has been overcome by some kind of fumes in his office. He's at General Hospital.
Yeah, I understand.
I'm going over there now.
Well, look, I'm glad you reached me. What do you want me to do?
Well, I'll make some kind of logical excuse to Spencer and go directly to Gerald's lab and run a check on all the security. Got it?
Oh, sure. I'd be happy to cooperate. Thank you for reaching me.
So, who's the mysterious boyfriend?
It's the manager of my hotel.
What?
Yeah, apparently one of the porters was caught breaking into my room, so they want me to check my valuables.
Now?
Yeah, look, I'll grab a cab and I'll meet you back at the casino.
Yeah, fine. So how did they know that you were here?
They telephoned the casino and one of the bartenders overheard that we were coming here for your interview.
I'm sure you don't want me to go with you.
Oh. No, that's really sweet of you, but I think one of us ought to be back at the casino. Look, I'll see you back there, okay?
Yeah, that's fine. Would you do me a favor?
Your wish is my command.
Good. Would you tell Scorpio the next time he wants you to check Gerald's lab for security, save his dime, just walk over to the table like a regular person?
You two are smart for your own good.
I've heard that.
Are we ready?
Oh, all right, I guess so. Holly?
I think I'm going to stay and have a nightcap. I'll walk home.
Oh, well, we could have another cup of coffee with you. But honestly, I've got a lot of work piled up at home. I'm rather anxious to get at it.
Oh, I understand perfectly. I'll walk home. I'll enjoy it.
Well, I don't know. I promised Robert I'd see you safely home.
Darling?
Yes?
Well, Holly just said she'd enjoy the walk, so shall we go?
Whatever you say. Good night, Holly.
Good night.
Good night, Holly. Enjoy the walk.
Thank you. You a drink. Would you stay and have it with me?
Right.
Great. stingers, please.
Right, of course.
On the rocks. You do like stingers, don't you?
You know I do.
So do I, periodically.
I know, you taught me.
So, did you enjoy dinner?
I suppose so. Did you?
Well, tell you the truth, I don't remember. I imagine you were engrossed in conversation about the campaign.
Almost exclusively. Oh. Good luck.
Thank you. You do mean that. I mean, I thought you were on the opposite side, aren't you?
Do you want an honest answer?
I expect one. I always did, and I always will.
I could never be against you, Luke, never.
No matter what I did?
Did or said. I was going to say, maybe that's all love is, hurting one another.
You don't believe that for a second.
No?
No. At least you didn't used to believe that. With us, it was much more. Much more. Wasn't it?
I don't like remembering.
But you do remember.
Yes.
So do I.
Is it painful?
Remembering? Yes. I go through something else, and I wonder if you do.
Go through what?
Well, it's kind of bizarre. I feel your presence. I mean, like tonight. I walk into a place, I sit down, and before I even see you, I know that you are.
Happens to me too.
What fools these mortals be, eh? Shakespeare.
Actually, Seneca said it a lot before that, about 8 AD, I think.
How did you know that?
I didn't until a little while ago. I've been reading a lot lately.
Holly?
Yes.
Now,
I think I shall go.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm very sure. But getting back to the honesty.
Yes.
I do wish we could be friends.
Well, you and I could never be friends. I think we both know that.
Yes, I'm afraid we do.
English. I miss you.
drink a lot?
Then tonight's an exception.
Yeah, so is mine. Frustration on all sides.
Can I pour you a brandy? It'll make you feel better.
No, thanks.
At least I wouldn't be drinking alone.
Maybe later. I shake some of the evening off.
You said you were feeling frustrated.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
Maybe it's the human condition, Robert.
It's part of it. But there are other parts. Compensations.
Do you feel compensated?
When I look at you. You know what was going through my mind?
I'll never be able to guess that, Robert.
I was thinking to myself, hey, Robert. So the evening was a foul-up. Look what you've got to come home to.
What?
Very beautiful. Very appealing wife. She's a cure for all my ailments. You're all I need, Holly. All I ever will need.
Sorry.
Something I said?
No, it's me. It's just there are some times when I need some space. I hope you understand.
Well enough to know this is one of those times.
Yes, it is. Sorry.